Hi guys, adding wireless connectivity to any embedded system project make the project look better and easy to use as well. And the cheapest way to achieve this is to use these 433 MHz based cheap RF modules. So today in this video we will talk about these cheap RF modules and we will learn how to use in our project. So without wasting any more further time, let's do this. So guys, long time back I made a video about these cheap RF modules because they can be used independently with encoder and decoder IC in any project and that was easy and very cheap. But application of that kind of project is limited. So if you want to see that video then the link is in card section as usual. So the application of this RF module is limited with encoder and decoder ICs. So I thought of using these modules with microcontrollers so that we can use it according to our need in our project. And in our case we'll be using Arduino Uno. And for programming purpose we'll be using our Arduino IDE as usual. But we'll be needing a RF library for this. So I'll be using Radiohead library. You can get the link in description for the library. So download the library and install that zip library in your Arduino IDE. And after that you can download my code from description as well. So before we go into the coding stuff, let's talk about the circuit part of this project. So first let's talk about the transmitter circuit. So we need to connect VCC pin to 5 volt pin and the ground to ground. And the data pin of the transmitter to the pin 12 on Arduino. Now, let's talk about receiver circuit. So we need to connect VCC to 5 volt and ground to ground as usual. And the shown data pin in schematics to the pin 11 on Arduino. So our receiver and transmitter both circuits are ready. And you can see my receiver and transmitter code in the screen as well. And both codes are very simple. So in transmitter code you can see that it is sending hello world message every second. And now in receiver code it is receiving a message of 12 characters long. And whenever it is receiving a message it will print it on the serial monitor. So I will upload both of these codes to receiver and transmitter circuits of Arduinos. And I'll open the serial monitor for Arduino with receiver to read the messages. And you can see that since we did everything correct, now we are receiving hello world message on the serial monitor. Now let's try one more example of mine. So we will try to send a key press from the transmitter side with the help of a push button to turn on the LED on the receiver side. So in this example from transmitter side, we will send two messages and one is turn LED on. And it will be sent whenever switch at pin 7 is pressed. And turn LED off will be sent whenever switch is not being pressed. And whenever you are sending these messages, make sure they are 12 characters long. Because at the receiver side, it is expecting 12 characters long message. So if you are sending say 11 characters message, so at the receiver end, the 12th character will be some junk character. So in my case, to make my message one of 12 characters long, I added this exclamation mark at the end of the message. Now let's see the receiver code. So here we are receiving the message. Then we are converting this in a proper usable string format. Then if that message is equal to our turn LED on message, so it will turn the LED on. And if it is something else, say turn LED off. If that is received, then it will turn the LED off as usual. So I will attach a LED at pin 13 of Arduino with receiver and a switch on the pin 7 of Arduino with transmitter. Now let's upload both of these codes to their appropriate Arduinos. So after uploading of code, now you can see that whenever I press the switch, then the LED on the Arduino with receiver lights up. So similarly, you can send as much as messages you want to trigger with multiple conditions and multiple LEDs or any other output component or device. So guys, that's all for today. I hope you like this video. If you do, hit like, give me a share, and don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you guys in another video of mine. Till then, keep exploring.